Seymour Micro Software has all the usual drawing aids to help make your job easier on these toolbars up here, and there's some down here. Note that you can move these. For the purposes of this video, let's put all of our drawing aid toolbars down here at the bottom. Let's go take a look at screen 6 down here. If you select a text object like this one, then all the objects that are applicable to this box that are currently grayed out will light up. So let's click on that object, and sure enough, the objects that we can use are all turned on. In particular, note that we can change the size of the text in that box without having to open up the dialog and edit it there. That's a real time saver. If you select the line object, you can quickly adjust the weight, just cycling through the options. Adjust the style just by clicking. It rotates through the various options, and whether or not it has an arrow on one end, the other, or both. Again, I'm just clicking on this button. Let's go back to screen 1. Once you've selected an object, you have all the usual cut, copy, and paste options right here. So I can cut it out, paste it back, paste multiple copies. If I didn't like that, I can undo it or redo it and make copies instead of cuts and paste those. Let's undo all that. Let's go to screen 2, where if you select a group of objects, let's select that one. I'm holding down the control key right now, selecting 3 objects. Then the alignment tools become available. This will align the object's left sides. This will align their centers. And this will align their right sides. Down on screen 5, we have some horizontal objects. If we select all of those, then we can align their top sides, middles, or bottom edges. You can also force all objects, let's grab these 3 for example, to be the same size vertically, horizontally, let me undo a couple of those, or both at the same time. You can also group objects, so you can move them all as a group or ungroup them. You can also bring an object to the front, clicking on this button, or send it to the back, or move it up or down a level, one at a time. Down here, you can turn the grid on, make objects snap to the grid, and change the grid size. Let's change it to a 20 by 20. Whoops. The grid won't show up on the user display. This is simply to help you align things when you build your display. Finally, you can zoom to one of 8 levels or have your own custom level. Now here on this little 3-inch screen, it's not that big of a deal, but on the high-res panels, it's a big help that makes your life a lot easier. One side note, when you select objects to use these sizing tools, the order in which you select the objects is important. For example, if I select this object first and then this object, and I say make them both the same size, they're going to make them all the same size as the first object. Let me undo that. Let's do it the other way. Let's make this the first object and select these 2. Now if I press this button, they all conform to the first object selected. So beware when you're selecting things. That's about all there is for using the drawing tools. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.